Hey y'all, SurfinSapo here. Today is January 20th, 2018. We've let the Tasso marinate for the last 72 hours, and now we're gonna smoke it, okay? This is the smoker we're gonna use. I just purchased this master build. It's a portable, so I could take it to the beach. I'll show you more about this in a second, but let's go ahead and prep the Tasso up for smoking, all right? Get this. This is for the hand. It's very messy. Here's how they look. Pat them. I'm probably going to do three because the little smoker doesn't have much capacity. We'll talk more about that in a second. Three for the film, that is. I'll do the rest in a bit. Okay. Just following directions. It says dry it off. It's kind of hard to dry stuff off over here in the humidity. Sun kind of came out a second ago, but it went back in. You can smell garlic from the seasoning. Smells good. Okay, we'll do 3K to start off with for sake of time. Okay, let me get this paper towel kind of to the side. Same spice as before. Okay. And we're gonna coat it heavily again. Cause that's what it's supposed to be, super spicy. Heavily. This isn't for the faint-hearted, okay? This smells really good, by the way. This seasoning. $2 for this big old tub. Not bad. Tony's and Conrico is like ridiculously priced. Alright. Here we have it. Alright, got it on there. Now, take her over to the smoker and load in some chips and whatnot and some pellets, and we'll get her going, okay? Okay, here's the smoker. Kind of retrofit it. When I say that, I've added a piece of foil here and a piece of foil there, trying to keep the temperature down. I can't get it very low with the door shut, with all the vents shut, so we'll just go with what we have. This is a hickory mixed with oak right here. As far as the pellets are oak, the chips are hickory. So that's what we're going to go with. Try to just push that back up in there and hope for the best. Okay, I'm going to put it up here on the highest rack, the Tasso. Try to. Don't make it too much of a mess. If it'll fit. This thing's real tiny. It's made for the beach. Portable. Yeah, I might have to put one lower. See, now you see why I can't do all of them? Oop, get back. Over here. So I'll put one here. It's got this foil there to guard it. This is gonna be an all-day affair, I could tell. Oop, let me pull that out first, folks. $99 plus a $30 gift card. This isn't a bad little smoker. Oop, get over there. Alright, there we go. That's how we see it. I'm gonna put it in here. We can bump the temp up real quick so that you can see how the smoke starts. Shouldn't take that long. Let me see what we got. If I can zoom y'all in. I'll try to talk about the features of this. You probably can't see it, but right here there's a little burner inside there with a metal thing over it, and then there's a hole on the top and then the chips go above that. So the fire heats the whole thing up, and then the other fire heats the chips and the pellets up, and that's what gives you your smoke. But I want to try to smoke this at the lowest temperature that I could get on this. With the door shut, the lowest goes about 225, and I don't think that's low enough for Tasso. So I might have to crack the door just a little bit, and some smoke's gonna come this way instead of through the vents. But I think it'll be enough. There, we have some smoke now, if you can see. Let's see. We're having a little bit of smoke now. See? Starting to smoke. So with that being said, let's go ahead and shut it. Next time I see you, it should be virtually ready, the first batch. Okay, folks, it's 4 hours later. I've taken the first batch off and took them into the oven, got it to 150 degrees. I took them off of the smoker, which is working wonderful now that it's broken in. I took them off the smoker at 125 degrees. Now I'm gonna bring them up to a little bit more, probably 145 in the house. They got plenty of smoke. I mean, look at this. Look at this batch. And that's a lot of smoke right there, letting it out. I even went ahead and threw a few Opa sausages, jalapeno cheese in there to cook while the Tasso is smoking. So this has worked out very well now that I kind of got used to it. So next time when we come back, we'll see the Tasso from the kitchen that's finishing off in the oven, okay? And this batch will have to go in there in another 4 hours. So I bought a pretty good sized pork butt. They sliced it. It was about what did I say in the first video? 6.21 pounds, something like that. So that's a pretty good size. Okay, so we'll see you then. Okay, after many, many hours of out back feeding oak and hickory into the little smoker, we finally finished. Got 6 chunks of Tasso. Let's just take a look at it. It smoked good. It got up to about 140 degrees internal. Take a look at that. It's all smoked. It's real nice and dark. I'll probably individually wrap these in food saver bags or just baggies. I don't know. We'll see. And then deep freeze them for later use in beans, jambalaya, gumbo, whatever. But it's, in fact, I want to tell you what I did. This one, and this one were only marinated in the marinade. These three were marinated. These were the original three that had the extra coating of Cajun seasoning. So they're like super spicy and salty. It really smells good. But these ones are just more smoky. They still have the marinade from the 72 hours. But these ones have the extra. So made it a little bit different. So we'll call this spicy and medium, because there ain't nothing mild about this. Okay. All right, well, that's about it. From here, we'll test it out on some recipes coming up very soon, maybe next week. Make some beans, or we'll see. I'll do some research and find some recipes that call for Tasso. And we'll go from there, okay, folks? Well, thanks for watching. Hope you learned something. I sure did. And please subscribe, share with all your friends, all social medias that you have, go ahead and share it. And subscribe, of course, if you're not. And leave a comment. I'd like to hear from you. If I don't get back to you right away, give me a while, because I'm one of them natural-born procrastinators. All right, y'all, that's it. God bless. We'll see you next time. Adios, amigos.